Today's topic that I'd like to speak about is partnerships and partnership agreements. We can go on for hours and hours talking about this topic. However, I'll try to sum it up in a few minutes, and details could always be filled in at a later date. When we talk about partnerships, I mean partners in partnerships and also shareholders in corporations. For this topic, it's all the same because we're dealing with the people that are involved in a business. I always like to say that the only time you should go into partnerships is if you could adhere to a mathematical formula, which is 1 + 1 = 3. In other words, if you have two people getting together and each contributes 50% of his effort of the company, and together they have a company and then they share the profits 50%, you really didn't accomplish anything. You're putting in your time together with somebody else and you're only taking out half of it. So you might as well stay on your own and not go into partnerships. If there are two partners that together 1 + 1 = 3, so each one benefits from the other's involvement in the company, and a partnership in that case can work. However, when two people get together, they have to have a division of duties. If each one is going to do what the other one is doing, then basically you're duplicating the effort and you're not accomplishing much for the business. So going into a partnership, each one should know what his duty in the company is. Some people are good on the inside, called the inside man. Some are good on the outside, sales. Some are good in finances, in bookkeeping, in paperwork. Some are good in negotiating. They should have in the beginning a division of duties so one doesn't step on the other one's shoulder. A common question that occurs, which we can deal with in a very lengthy seminar, but just some pointers. What happens if two people get together, and this is typical, one supplies the money and the other one supplies the effort? In other words, one is going to be a silent investor. He's going to put up all the money with all the money responsibility, but the other one is going to run the company. What typically happens is, how do these people get rewarded? The person that's putting in work has to earn a salary. What are his wages? Person that's putting in money, he's putting in money, that has a price also. Money has a price. I like to suggest that to keep it on an equal playing field, each of these two partners should get what the market bears. In other words, a person putting in money, he should be getting the typical interest rate on his money that he put in. The person that's putting in the work should get paid what commensurate with his experience and his ability and what it takes on the market. So in other words, once the money partner is getting paid for putting in his money, and once the working partner is getting paid for putting in his work, they're both on an equal playing field. So one can't say to the other, look how much work I'm doing. Well, you're getting paid. The other one says, look at the risk I'm taking, I'm putting in money. Well, you're getting paid. You get paid interest commensurate with your risk. Therefore, they're on an equal playing field and nobody is going to be beholden to the other. In that way, it's a healthy partnership. It's a partnership that could exist for a long time as long as each one is getting paid what they should get paid.